Hi there. I want to do a lesson giving you an example of some different ideas you can do using two-handed tapping across multiple different strings. I figured the best way to teach you this type of thing was just to give you some ideas so you can play around with it on your own. So with that in mind, here's the lick I want to teach you. As you can see, it's really kind of flashy. It goes across most of the different strings, but it's actually pretty simple to do it. It's a lot more coordination than it is speed. So once you get down the individual notes, it's really just going to be a matter of getting it up to speed rather than like you having to develop any muscles or anything like that. So again, it sounds like this. It's based on the blues scale in E minor, the E blues scale. So, played slowly, it sounds like this. I'll do the whole thing and then I'll give you the notes. And it goes like this, starting on the 12th fret of the high E, hammer on to the 15th fret, tap the 17th, slide up to the 18th, slide down to the 17th, pull off to the 15th, pull off to the 12th. Then after that, hammer on to the 15th fret, tap the 17th, pull off to the 15th, pull off to the 12th. That's what you're playing. After that, you're going to go down to the B string, and you're going to start that string ring by tapping the 17th fret. Pulling off to the 15th, and pulling off to the 12th. As you can see too, you're hitting the same notes that you pull off to the 12th fret on the high E, with then the next one, the tap note, the 17th fret on the B. Then going down the G string, you start by tapping the 15th fret on the G string, sliding up to the 16th, sliding down to the 15th, pulling off to the 14th, pulling off to the 12th. Okay, so after you pull off to the 12th, you then tap the 14th, tap the 15th, pull off to the 14th, pull off to the 12th. So, like that, and then you do, on the D string, you tap the 17th fret, pull off to the 14th, pull off to the 12th. As you can see, you did the same type of pattern as far as going up and down on the high E and B, or, and then down to the G and the D. And then finishing off on the A string, the way you get out of this, you start by tapping with your left hand the 14th fret, tapping the 17th fret, pulling off to the 14th, pulling off to the 12th, hammering on the 14th, and then I do a double tap on the 17th, pull off to the 14th, pull off to the 12th, slide down to the 10th. And that's it, that's the whole line. It goes all the way from the top to the bottom, basically, and it's really flashy. So, how to practice this, basically set a metronome, whatever I'm gonna go, to speed you're comfortable with. And just kind of do it over and over again. You get the idea. Sorry, it's late, I'm a little tired, not doing a job. But yeah, just play it slowly with the metronome, do it in time, and then you work your way up. And you'll be surprised how fast you get it. Just because one thing with these things to keep in mind, like I said before, is that it's coordination more than it is speed. So you'll be surprised. Once you get the different rhythms down, it's just a matter of basically having it enter into your muscle memory and then getting up to speed. So I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks.